To have a consistent and functional worldview, one must have absolute standards and laws. If one asserts laws that do not come from God's revealed word, these assertions will be self-contradictory and self-defeating. When the non-Christian claims that there are no absolutes, he is asserting an absolute standard and a law, a standard that is self-stultifying. The statements that there are no absolutes is an absolute statement. This statement is a contradiction and self-refuting. For it to be true, it would have to be false, therefore it can only be false. There must be absolutes in logic and in morality, or we can assert nothing and account for nothing that is impossible. Unchanging standards do not reside in matter and cannot be empirically quantified, examined, or put into a flask. They cannot be human conventions or subjective theories made up by mutable men. The absolutes of ethics transcend time, space, and matter and cannot be tested in a lab. But all labs assume absolutes and use them in all their science. They cannot solely be the result of neuron firings in the brain, because that would make them mutable, and by definition, they would not be laws. The material only atheists cannot explain from where laws come or justify them, any more than the frontal lobe challenged boxer Riddick Bowe. It was Bowe, reported in the Las Vegas Review-Journal, who kidnapped his wife because he wasn't thinking correctly. This mistaken attempt to get his family together was blamed on the frontal lobe damage from years of boxing. He later admitted that his lawyers cooked up the idea to try to keep him out of jail. Much of our legal system is based on relativism and not the pursuit of truth. Thus, Bowe and his lawyers never even blushed in their admission of this fraudulent defense. The notion of morals without absolutes must be rinsed out of our culture or our social structure. Our social structures will crumble from within. Philosophically and theologically, this concept is easily refuted. If one claims that there are no absolutes, one is employing absolutes to make this claim. Again, this means the claim is self-negating. It cannot be true. Buy this book at MikeARobinson.com.